the only one. You ever felt like that? I'm the only one who cares. I'm the only one in this marriage who cares. I'm the only one carrying this responsibility. I know you felt this way as a leader before, Chet. I'm the only one who sees what needs to be done. And God told him, go back the way you came, because I've already got somebody to support you. His name is Elisha. It sounds a lot like yours, because y'all are meant to go together. And when you get to him, I want you to take your cloak and throw it on him. And I know you feel alone, but I've got somebody plowing the field right now. I don't mean to turn this into a dating seminar, but sometimes we get so lonely, and in our seasons of loneliness, we isolate. But God said, I have put somebody in your path. I have put somebody, even if you are not married right now, even if you don't have the support system you want right now, I know what that feels like. I've been lonely and I am married. I've been lonely and I have kids. I've been lonely in this room filled with 2,000 people, and they were shouting, and on the inside I was crying, and on the outside I was smiling, but on the inside I was crying, and nobody knew what I was carrying, and nobody knew what had just happened 30 minutes ago backstage, and nobody knew the hate that I was dealing with from critics, but I had to smile and show love. And see, in these moments of isolation, you might feel like the only one, but God has somebody for you. God, even if it's just this moment, what if God sent this message today? You've been on the brink of suicide. You've been on the brink of giving up, and God prompted my heart to come in this room and put Holly and Todd and Doug and all them, and they're back there, but it's just the two of us right now, and God is trying to bring you back to a place of understanding that before you even asked, he answered. He hears before I call.